Thank you. Thank you. Light cannot enter a closed room. A pearl cannot form in a closed oyster. God does not force us into relationship. It is we who must take down the walls we have built, who must open the door. Love stands at the door and knocks, and it is we who must open the door to let the light come in.
Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David.
As king, he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land.
In his days, Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security.
This is the name they gave him, the Lord our justice.
On that day, a shoot shall sprout up from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom.
The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him.
A spirit of wisdom and understanding.
A spirit of counsel and of strength.
A spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord.
And his delight shall be the fear of the Lord.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone.
Thank you. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world.
Thank you. There are three parts to this season, the waiting, and the waiting, and the waiting. Waiting for the Christ child to come, to be sure, who we know already came. Waiting for the burning coming of the Christ in our hearts, for the I am with you always. Waiting for the great coming of the reign of God when each table is a banquet and bread lines are no more. There are three comings to this season, and three waitings, and three yearnings, and God, the answer to all of them.
Oh.
In Bethlehem, in a small town nestled in the hills, overshadowed by mighty Jerusalem to the north. In Bethlehem, small among the clans of Judah. In Bethlehem, the humble, earth met sky, heaven met earth, time and space ripped, silently, silently. God met human, eternal met earthly, past and future narrowed, silently, silently. In a birth, in a newing, in a burst of star song, silently, silently, God has lifted up the lowly. Blessed are the humble, for they shall see birth.
Still, still, still.
You will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation to his people by the forgiveness of their sins. By the tender mercy of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us, to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Gloria.
A star is risen in the east.
The bright, the morning star.
Light.
Both wave and particle.
Light.
Both substance and energy.
Christ.
Both particle and wave, both earthly and holy.
And all of us, with unveiled faces, are being transformed into that image from one degree of glory to another.
Christ.
Deus de Deum.
God from God.
Lumen de Lumine.
Light from light.
There is a group of plants called heliotropic. They turn toward the light.
Faces toward the star. Light from light.
And from that light, both wave and particle, they live and are transformed and give back to the universe beauty.
And peace.
And heaven.
Let us look at this holy day we celebrate each year in the middle of the cold and dark time, the gray and the sleeping time, in the middle of the season of seeming death and dormancy. We sing down birth in the midst of the season of twilight days. We sing down stars in the chill and the hollow days of winter. We sing down love in the days of white and gray and black. We sing down red and green, spring colors, birth colors, flower colors, growth colors. Even in the cold and dark time, spring can appear, if only for a flash, if only for a twelfth night, to remind us that the divine can spring up in unlikely places, in unlikely times.
I'd like to welcome you all to this year's Christmas concert here at Good Shepherd. First of all, thank you for all coming. Thank you to these 50-some musicians here up in front who have given so much time and energy and dedication to this program. This next piece is called Gloria, and as we sing it, we will take an offering. We will pass plates through the pew. If you've been inspired tonight, feel free to put something in the plate. All of the monies collected tonight will go to support Good Shepherd's music ministry, to continue the music such as you hear tonight and future concerts. I'd also like to invite you all to a reception following the program today. in the lobby at the coffee bar. We nicknamed this program Music Monday Christmas Edition because in the summer we have Music Mondays out on the lawn at the Madison campus. We bring in various groups. Tonight's no exception, we're just inside. So the Holy Cow, Good Shepherd's Church on Wheels, will be providing cookies, hot chocolate, and coffee. So once again, I thank you all for coming tonight. Merry Christmas, and thank you.
Thank you.
sky began at the shepherd's feet and rose to the calming blue, blue of clarity, color of Mary, blue of compassion, midnight blue of possibility, waiting. Blue curtain of the night's tabernacle, waiting for divinity. And out of the blue, a cloven sky, blue and gold and startling white, chords, clusters, songs, sounds, layer upon layer, celestial polyphony. The night stars with myriad voices gathered. The night stars with riven light welcomed. With arc of golden wing, with scintilla of holiness, the night stars sang with light the coming of their brother, the bright and morning star.
Thank you.
The eye can see the light of a candle 10 miles away, 10 miles away. The eye grasps and holds that pinpoint of light, one candle, hope. But what we have been promised in our darkness, what has been pledged in our night, is far more. What has been promised is a brilliance of a full dawning, the explosive brightness of full day, light, the sum of all colors, Christ, the sum of all existence, streams extravagantly over the horizon and pierces and pushes, and the hard and helpful night relinquishes its place, waiting to be called forth again.
God, creator of the stars of night, blessed are you, for you fill all creation with your holy light. So dwell in us that we too may be light in the darkness, warmth in the cold night, hope in the shadows, love in the dark hour. Amen.
Who sent the bright angel choirs, bless us.
May God who brought the light to those in darkness, guide us.
May God whose spirit burns in us, keep us.
May our hearts know peace.
May the world know peace. Amen.